they had me in plaid for a little bit. They were really rocking the plaid vibe. And then it got to a point where I was like, okay guys, we're gonna need to back it up on the plaid, please, and the leather jackets. My name is Rowan Grace. I'm from Rapid City, South Dakota. I am 17 years old. I'm in a good mood today. I'm feeling good. I'm excited to do this. The lowest note, let's see. I'm like in school, I'm in choir, so I'm like a second soprano, so I'm like in that higher-ish, middle-ish range, so probably not that low, but let's just see how low I can go. Probably, whatever that is. Someone can fact check that. Whatever that note is, that's the lowest I can go today. I can't guarantee that I could go lower or whatever next. Oh God, the highest note I can sing. Probably pretty high if I'm like warmed up. I've gotten pretty high up there, warmed up, but let's see. Where should we start? Whatever that is, that's today's highest note.
Yeah, let's not break your voice.
Right, we don't want to like break anything, right? My favorite movie. I love rom-coms and like this. I like to watch all kinds of movies. I watch like adventure movies and stuff with my dad and like Marvel movies with my dad. But I think like my guilty pleasure and like my favorite movie is 10 Things I Hate About You. It's like my favorite rom-com. This is hard. I think I'm just gonna pick a Beatles song because these are like lyrics I wanna get tattooed on me one day because I love this song so much. The Long and Winding Road by the Beatles. It's one of my favorites. I've been inspired by the Beatles all growing up. My grandma played the Beatles for me all the time. She was a huge fan of them. And so she would always play that music for me and sing it to me all the time. So I kind of grew up on the Beatles. And I think I'm really inspired by a lot of like George Harrison and Paul McCartney's songwriting specifically, so them. But also recently, I've been really inspired by upcoming people that are younger, like Olivia Rodrigo or Lizzie McAlpine. Like those are some of my two new, like recent favorites that inspire me a lot. I have not met any of them. I've been able to meet very cool and amazing and inspiring artists in my life that I would say inspire me too. Like I would say Gwen Stefani's like alternative like punk rock music is something that I always wanted to do and I still want to do, like that upbeat rock. I just love that, and I love No Doubt, and of course, so I've actually got to meet her, and so I would say she's like my influence that I've been able to meet. Well, this is tough because I have a lot of people that I would like want to work with or have the honor to work with. I think someone that I would have always said ever since I was little is like Adele. I just love her so much, and I watch her interviews all the time. She just seems like a really cool person to just be around. She also seems like she knows a lot. She has a really powerful voice, and I feel like I'd be able to learn a lot from her. So probably her, or in recent times, I think it would be cool to collaborate with Olivia Rodrigo. She's super inspiring to me. You know, she is young and in the music scene at a young age, and that's really inspiring to me. Oh my gosh, I'd love to visit Greece. I've always wanted to visit Greece ever since watching Mamma Mia when I was really little. And ever since then, it's been like my dream place to go. Anytime anybody asks me, I'm like, I wanna go to Greece. I can't wait. It's like a bucket list thing for me. Favorite color? My favorite color is green, probably. I love green. I think I know. I have 18.2 thousand Instagram followers, which is crazy to me. I can't even believe that. Probably Gwen Stefani is the most famous person that follows me. I'm pretty sure she follows me. I don't know what the word is, but she's just super kind, very, very relaxed and calm. I guess I don't know what I expected her to be like, but it wasn't that. But she's super kind. Even when she was like giving us critiques, it sounded like she was just giving us a compliment because she would say it in like the nicest way possible. I think the biggest thing to happen in my career so far is being on the television show The Voice. That was a huge, huge boost in my career. Got me to meet so many influential people in my life. You know, got a lot of people around South Dakota and around like the world to know who I am, which is just insane. When filming that, like I basically lived in Burbank, California for like months, and it was just insane. It was just a really unbelievable experience. So growing up, I had watched American Idol and The Voice and America's Got Talent and like all those competition shows with my dad. And I never really was into American Idol that much because it looked really scary to be a contestant on that show, because sometimes they would do things like challenges where they had to like stay up all night and work with random people and do all these crazy things. And I was like, that scares me. I don't know if I'd be able to do that. Plus, that's not really what the music business is like anyway, so I wouldn't want to put that type of pressure on myself. But I really liked the production of The Voice. It just seemed really interesting to me, you know, how they were in such cool clothes up there, and it just was really interesting to me. I have auditioned for all of them. I've auditioned for America's Got Talent and American Idol, and of course The Voice a couple of times until I got that final yes. It's a really cool story too, because I have to give a little bit of credit to my dad, you know. I had auditioned for the first time when I was 13 years old. That's the youngest you can be when you can audition. And so that's when I first auditioned, and I did an open call, and that was pre-COVID. And so it was like in San Francisco, I'm pretty sure. And I went to an open call with this huge ballroom. We were waiting all day for this one chance to be in this room and do it. And it went well. The guy held me and this other girl back, and he was like, we like you, but we want to wait like a couple years. So we're gonna take your information and we'll contact you and that kind of stuff. And I was like, oh my God, that's so good. I'll take that. And then it was like a win for the day. But then COVID happened, and so it kind of went all virtual. And so it was a lot more convenient to audition. And so that's what I did. I was just sending in videos here and there ever so often. I had one audition where I got pretty far in the callback process, but then I didn't make it through, and it was the one time where it really got my hopes up, and then I was kind of discouraged from it. So I think at that moment I was like, I probably won't audition again. In December of 2021, my dad was like, November, he was like, you can send in a video to The Voice, like, I think you should, like, just do this open call. And I told him, I was like, I don't know, I don't really want to submit again because I don't want to be let down again. And I was kind of just being really down on myself, but my dad saw it in me, and he was like, just do this one more time. I won't ask you again. You can just do it this one more time. And I was like, okay, yeah, I'll do it. Then I got on the show, and I was like, oh my God, there's no way this is real life. And so I have to thank my dad for giving me the little nudge to audition again. The Voice has you compile this list of like 1 to 15 of songs that you would want to sing on the show. And they kind of pick the song for you. But fortunately for me, my number one song on my list was Traitor. And that was the song that they picked for me. I originally picked that song because I like singing slower songs, more ballady songs when it comes to showcasing my voice. That was like the perfect thing for my first impression on this show, you know, because you really want them to see every aspect of your voice, and you also want the coaches to see where they can help you grow from there. Also, Olivia Rodrigo is a newer artist, up and coming, and she really inspires me because, like I said, she's a young artist up and coming, and that's like me right now, and her things that she's accomplishing are all goals of mine. And so she really inspires me, so I thought that was amazing, and I feel like they would see that connection, which they did. A lot of my songs that I sang on that show, the thing that mattered to me the most was that I was going to be able to tell a story and convey a story through my songs, because I'm a songwriter, and that's like my favorite thing to do, is tell a story through a song. So I felt like that song was had such a good story behind it, and something that I could connect to. Okay, this is good. Okay, my favorite outfit. So they had me in plaid for a little bit. They were really rocking the plaid vibe. And then it got to a point where I was like, okay guys, we're gonna need to back it up on the plaid, please, and the leather jackets. Cause I have two plaid and leather jacket outfits, and then another one that's just a leather jacket. But I think my favorite one is the one that I wore when I performed with Blake. I loved that outfit so much. I loved my hair. They put like jewels, like little diamond jewels, like down my part. It was so cool. And it was super comfortable. So it was super cute, but it was comfortable. And also, I liked wearing pants the most, and those were like the comfiest pants ever. And then if you can see, I'm wearing like mega platform Docs. Like I wore Docs the whole show because those were my favorite. My stylist would bring in all sorts of colors of Docs and we just try them all on, pick them out. There was like purple, white, there's big ones, small ones. It was like everything. I think my favorite performance from The Voice was Landslide, which was the final performance that I did on the show. That one was my favorite one because I love Fleetwood Mac, I love Stevie Nicks. That song is just such a beautiful song. It's another great storytelling song. It was also like, I don't know, I just felt so content after that performance with like leaving of that being my last performance. And I had been sick for the 2 weeks prior performances for like two of the shows. I was like getting sick and it was only getting worse. So on that day, I, you know, barely had a voice in the morning. And I was like, I'm just gonna start chugging water and taking all these things and hoping and praying that it works out. And then, you know, in that moment, it was like the most nerve-wracking moment ever, probably. And it just reminds me of like how proud I am that I went up there and my voice just, it did what it needed to do. And I was like, oh my God, thank you for my voice actually coming out and not like nothing coming out. So yeah, I just love that performance in general for a ton of reasons. And it felt like the perfect way to end my place on the show. I feel like I get recognized more often than I thought I would. It's different every time, but usually by like one person. Every time I'm like in a super public area, at least one person, one or two people. I remember when I first got back from the show, I went to Target and I went to Ulta, and within that I like met a bunch of people, took pictures with people. It was so insane. I was like, what is going on? I did not expect that. My dad had said, you know, you might get recognized. And I was like, psh, yeah, like whatever. But it actually happened. And I was like, oh my God, wow, this is like insane. And just people asking to take a picture with me. It's really cool too, just to like see that they were the ones supporting me and voting for me. It's cool to see that because, you know, I was all the way in LA and didn't really see that besides like on social media, but to actually see it face to face, the people that were supporting me, it's really cool to meet them and talk to them. It's so amazing. I mean, I think back to my blind audition. You know, we were there for a month before, and then at the end of the month, we recorded the blind auditions. And they had told us, you know, as we were there for a month, that some of you might not get auditions because, you know, if the teams fill up, like some, you know, there's nothing we can really do about that. And I understood that. And so that, you know, thinking about how that was my biggest anxiety of just like, I just wanna go on like one of the first few filming days just so I get a chance to audition in front of them. And then, you know, just going from being scared that I won't even get a blind audition to making it all the way to the top 10, being on two different teams, and getting to experience the live shows, it was just insane. I mean, my goal each time just got bigger and bigger. You know, after I got a blind audition and I got three chair turns, I was like, okay, my next goal is to win the battles. Like, I really wanna work hard and win the battles. And after I won the battles, I was like, oh my gosh, like, now my next goal is I just wanna get to the lives and then I'll be fine. I don't even care. Once I get to the lives, I'm good. And then I got to the lives and I was going on in lives. I was like, this is not real. Like, I just had to keep like pinching myself. So I was like, there's no way this is real. Like, if I could tell younger Rowan, who would watch the show with my dad all the time, and he'd say, you're gonna be up there one day. And I could tell her, like, you are gonna be up there one day. Like, it's just, she would be shocked and probably cry. A lot of my life is music, so that's a huge part of my life. But another thing that I really love to do is to dance and act. Those are my two other favorite things. I've been dancing ever since I was like 4 years old. That's kind of what my parents, you know, how my parents saw that I really had an like a niche for performing. So I started dancing really young. They put me in these dance classes and I like instantly fell in love. And it was perfect because that kind of is how I fell into acting as well, because I love to sing all the time and I love to dance all the time. So my grandma, who's super into theater, she took me to a show one time and it was Hairspray. And that was like the first musical that I saw. And I was literally like, my eyes were glued to the stage. All I wanted to do was get up and run on stage with them. And that's how I knew I wanted to perform in every kind of aspect possible. And so that's how I got me into theater. And I've been doing theater ever since I was like 9 years old. Oh my gosh, I talk to my family every single day. I am really close with my parents, and I have two younger sisters, and then I have an older brother that lives in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. I call him like every day. We write music together. He's super interested in music. He's not really like very musically inclined. Like, he doesn't sing and he doesn't really play any instruments or do any of that kind of stuff, but he does have an ear for music and what is good music. And he's good at writing really good like one-liners for me or helping me with songs. Anytime I'm just stuck in a spot, I text him, I send him this and I'm like, help. And he goes, you could rhyme with this really cool word. And I'm like, oh my God, you're a genius. And then I write it to it. And so we make a good team and we're really close too, especially because, you know, we don't really live near each other, but we try to talk as much as often. So I'm really close with my family. I'm a huge family gal. This is my dad. Come in, Dad. Let me move this water. Introduce my dad to the camera. Come in, say hi. This is my dad, Corey. You have anything to say, Dad?
I'm just so proud of you.
So proud of me?
Yep. Thanks. Can't wait to see what great things happen for you.
Thanks, you're a little high up. Man, I'll say it down. You're good. Love you.
I'm not in the screen.
Right. My dad was in a bunch of bands growing up. He's super into music as much as I am. And so he was in a bunch of bands growing up. And I would go to these band rehearsals with him. He would take me all the time. I'd just be his little buddy that would come and sit and just listen to them play all the time. And it was so fascinating to me. But I was never really watching my dad. I was watching kind of the singer. And that's how I kind of knew that I wanted to do this as like a career. I was like, oh my gosh, I want to be that singer right now. I want to go sing in front of these people and I want to do that. And that was like when I was like 6 and 7 years old. And so I always had that fire at a young age. And my dad saw that in me. You know, he saw that I was super excited to come to his band rehearsals and saw that I was super interested in singing and music. And he just asked me, he was like, do you want to do this? Like, is this something you would want to do as a career? And he's asking me this at like 8, 9 years old, but he just saw something in me. And I'm super grateful for that because I was like, yes, I do. And ever since then, we've been like this team. He is really great at finding me connections and finding me places to perform. That's, you know, that's how it all started. You know, he found out how I could audition for The Voice, and so I did. He's the one who took me to my audition in The Voice. My mom was great too, because she doesn't know all that stuff about it, but I have like two other siblings, and she really carried that weight of like my other sisters when my dad had to take me to these places. So just my parents have been like the whole reason why I'm here right now in this place doing these amazing things. I really wouldn't be able to do it without them. The biggest thing I've learned is to have fun and enjoy the things that you're doing, because I feel like there's been so many things in the past where I've been so nervous and so worried about how I'm doing or if I'm good enough or all those anxieties running through my head that I didn't like stop and take time to enjoy and have fun with what was happening. When you get really cool opportunities, just sit in it and be present and don't think about the future and don't think about the past. Just be present in where you are and have fun, because you know, the reason I do what I do, the reason I perform and write music and sing is because it fuels me with so much joy and happiness. It's so much fun. I love doing it. I love, love, love performing. Whenever I get off stage, I seriously feel like I could run a mile. Like, I just am so excited and it's so much fun. And so I think that's the biggest thing I learned. Have I ever been in love? I don't think so. I don't think I've ever been in love. I think I have really high standards, which is a good thing, but also a bad thing because I've never been in love yet. I don't know, I've always known my worth, and that's thanks to my mother and my grandmother, especially. You know, I've always set these high standards, but I'm actually glad because I don't wanna put myself in a situation where, you know, to be heartbroken or anything like that. I'm sure that'll happen, I'm sure it will. It's inevitable, right? But so far, no, I haven't been in love. I've kind of just been very friendship focused and career focused, to be honest. This is like so cliche, I guess. I don't know how else to say it. The only time that you're gonna be like truly happy with everything in your life is if you're happy with yourself. And that's a philosophy sometimes I still have to like sit back and think about on my own. You will never truly be happy in like a relationship or with another person if you're not happy with yourself and who you are as a person and confident in who you are as a person. And I think that's something that I've struggled with just because I'm really hard on myself all the time. So it's been hard finding confidence in things that I do, especially in something in a career where a lot of people are watching you and judging you, and you're doing the same thing to yourself. And so that's one of my biggest things, is just always, you know, try every day to work towards loving yourself. It's like so cliche, but it's so true. Like, just loving who you are will make you live your life so much, so much more happy, and just will allow you to just live a happier life in general. So basically, my philosophy is love yourself and work towards it every day. I'm opening for Lady A at the State Fair in Huron this year, and I still cannot believe that that's even real, because I would listen to Lady A growing up when I was really little in the radio all the time. So I think that'll probably be one of my bigger ones, and hopefully just getting bigger from there. I am constantly writing all the time. Currently trying to write an EP, you know, in the works of writing music, trying to release music as soon as possible. So, you know, when that music is ready, I will let everybody know on like all my social media and everywhere when that's ready. So definitely releasing music, also just performing more. I'm getting really cool opportunities to perform at really cool places, and I'm sure those will only keep coming. So performing, that's like another, it's my favorite thing to do ever. I love it. So getting ready to release music and performing. I'm starting to perform my original songs, which is really fun for me. It's so, I can't even describe the feeling of performing your own song. You know, I've always performed covers, but then being able to like sing your own music, it's such a great feeling. So definitely those two things, and just hopefully more amazing opportunities. I'm just gonna keep working hard, keep writing. I love writing. Yeah, keep moving forward.